Today in the city of Vancouver, we have gathered here to pray for the country of Canada and also for the Canadian people. Also, we have to know that there are lots of negative forces working, and there has to be some puja to be done to the Mahakali force. And so I thought today, let's have the puja for Mahakali. So Mahakali puja is the same as you do the Devi's puja. But first, the Mahakali force came on this earth. Adishakti came as Mahakali and created Sri Ganesha. Then she ascended as Mahasaraswati. And with that force, she created the whole universe. In that, she created this world in a very beautiful manner, with great arrangements and organizing. And on that were born human beings, because the temperature and all that was made very congenial for human beings. So this climate has also played a big part on the temperament of the people, on the seeking of the people. Like in India, we can say, the climate is very congenial for meditation. It has been a traditional country from ancient times. But from the very beginning, we have had seers who were seeking the truth in the jungles. The reason is this, that in India, its climate is so good that you can live in a jungle, no problem. So it was easy for them to get rid of all the superficialities of life and to take seriously, go to the jungles, dedicate themselves for finding out the truth. And thus they found out the truth, that it is the Kundalini, which is the force within us, which gives us realization. But this group then scattered in different places and they formed schools, were called, or universities, called as Gotras. And in these schools were sent children from the age of 5 years, till the 5 years they lived with their parents, and then these children were sent there. And they were given all the education about day-to-day life. Their education system was very different. By their education, they made the children very aware about everything. Concentration and a complete celibacy, because all the people in a gotra could not marry. Even today, supposing I belong to one gotra, I cannot marry a person in the same gotra. So it is so much maintained even today. Like in the university, you cannot marry each other. So the children were kept like brothers and sisters, and they felt it all the time, brothers and sisters, really. In the same way, see, it has worked out in many ways that the Muladhara Chakra was established very strongly in India. And that's why, though we had many other countries like China, we had old China was there, and also Egypt, then we had Greece, and also Rome. All these countries did not pay much attention to their Muladhara Chakra. And this Muladhara was created by the Mahakali. Mahakali created Sri Ganesha to emit holiness, auspiciousness, wisdom, divine wisdom. And her establishment of Sri Ganesha is also within us on the Muladhara Chakra. But if we do not pay attention to our Muladhara Chakra, then our powers become very weak and we start catching from negativity much more. Those who have good Muladharas do not catch so fast. But we are harmed more by people who are negative because they know that we have bad muladharas and they can affect us. Now all the gurus and all those false gurus came to Western countries because they knew they can affect much more here than in India. Like Rajneesh, nobody would accept such a man. Freud, nobody would accept such a person. But here already Freud had done the necessary harm to people and they were prepared to become vulnerable to these people. And on that background these people came here and started acting and they have been very successful. All of them have been found out to be very loose character and they have been exposed, and it's nice that whatever is negative, whatever is false gets exposed. But still one has to remember that if we have a strong Muladhara, then Mahakali power is the strongest within us. Because as I told you, first she created Sri Ganesha. So all her power are actually expressed in Omkara, which is Sri Ganesh. And this Sri Ganesh power within us represents the complete love of Mahakali and all her powers of destroying the evil forces. They go hand in hand, we should say, like every light has its glory around it, or glow around it. In the same way, the light of Mahakali has the glow as Chaitanya, which is actually nothing but Omkara and Sri Ganesha. Now Sri Ganesha has aspects, as I have told them, that if you see the carbon from the left, you see on the right side Omkar, Om written like that. If you see from right to the left, you see it as swastika. If you see from down below upward, then you see it as a cross. And now they have verified it, they have experimented, and the scientists have found out and have now declared that it is so. So that aspect of Omkara which is within us is the right side. But the left side is the swastika. And the swastika is a very, very sensitive instrument that if you use it on the right side, then of course it is all right. It works for construction, but if you use it for left side, I mean in the anti-clock manner, then it is destructive. So swastika, when it is moving in its right direction, clockwise in front and anti-clockwise at the back, if it is moving in the right direction, all negativity is thrown out on the periphery and absolutely they cannot enter it. But if it is moved on the left-hand side, then anybody can enter it. So it is, even if you move a swastika, see now, create a kind of a opening. If you make a swastika and see, it opens. But if you move it this way, there's no opening. It goes on closing one on another. So by moving it left side, it starts opening itself to these negative forces. This is exactly what has happened in the West, that they had their Muladhara moving on the left hand side, the anti-clockwise. They went against their own principle of morality, absolutely against Christ, and managed to get all these boots into themselves. Now, Sahaja Yoga has one problem in the West, that people don't want to hear that you should be moral. They find it very difficult. If you tell them you have to be moral, they think we are fundamentalist or something like that. But it's a fundamental thing that we have to be moral people. Now they are seeing the results of it, that they have got AIDS, they have got all these diseases, all these troubles. From that they are learning that our Muladhara should be all right, otherwise all these problems can come. But still they don't want to accept it, that they have done mistakes. So this is another ego problem, that they think, oh, they are very much glorified and they should be glorified, they did something new. I mean, if you go and cut your nose, you don't glorify such people. But something like that has happened, and this kind of a nonsense is still stabilized and people don't think much against it. But the sufferings are so much that whatever you may try, the sufferings are there. And they have to accept that they have gone wrong and they have done such a wrong thing. And that's what they deserve. But whatever it is, despite all their, you can say, the foolhardiness or tomfoolery, whatever you may call it, they are to be saved. And something has to be done for them. Because, after all, they are all seekers and they deserve to be saved. But with ego, they don't understand their own benevolence. To them, benevolence is that their ego should be satisfied. So Sahaja Yoga is not like this, that you just put some spirit into somebody and the person feels absolutely elated for a time being and then is finished. But it is something that has to grow. It's a living process. It grows within us. It takes time. And sometimes people get frustrated with it. But we should not. We should know we are the foundations and this is the most important work we are doing in the history of spirituality. So far, such work has not been done before. So, this is such a big thing that we are doing and we should be very satisfied with ourselves and should be confident because this requires people of quality. Not necessarily you should be well educated, you should be highly placed. Though to impress people might be, this might help, but still, if you are deep people, you can work out in no time. If the soil is not good, then the tree has to go deep down. In the same way, when the atmosphere is not good, we have to go deep down. But one should never feel frustrated. One should never feel upset. Because even if you are one person, you are a saint. And a saint brings all the luck, all the auspiciousness to that country. So there's nothing to feel in any way desperate or unhappy about. But try to develop your depth by meditation and by collective sitting down and talking to each other. I'm sure this will work out and this force of Mahakali will manifest. After this puja, I'm sure something tremendous should happen. As it is, you know that all these false gurus have been exposed and are put on the shelves now, most of them. Some of them have died, some of them exposed, some has happened. Gradually, they will all disappear. We don't have to worry about them. We have to worry about ourselves, that negativity should not crawl into us. And the negativity that falls into Sahaja Yogis is the frustration. That they feel we are very few, others are so many, why should we so few? I mean, it's all right. That has to be that way, it doesn't matter. And to have more people is not so important as we should have quality. You should have very good quality people who are deep, who understand Sahaja Yoga, who know it very well. Because even if you have too many and they don't know anything about Sahaja Yoga, they are useless. So not only that, you should have this love of God's divine nature, but also knowledge about Sahaja Yoga. Both things are the same. Actually, if you love someone, you know about that person, everything. When such a thing will happen all over the world that so many countries will accept Sahaja Yoga and so many will start talking openly about it on a very high level, then even the countries which have not been able to achieve much results, or we can say cities, will suddenly jump. I have great hopes from Toronto. Toronto will come up very well, I think, and I'm sure tonight also we'll have lots of people who will be sticking on. Because no use having 1,000 people and ultimately 2 turn up, that sort of common experience. So this would be a better idea. And today's prayer should be in our hearts that let us get very powerful Ganesha Shakti. Let us get that. And second should be that this Shakti should destroy all that is negativity. Even not to be collective itself is a negativity. all these collectivity problems or all these negativity problems must be destroyed by this Mahakali power which will manifest through us. May God bless you.